Good afternoon, everybody. Today I'm just going to do a short video on my Mossy Grand Corso Aluminum with 105. And of course, the flagship, the Super 6 Evo Cannondale, full carbon fiber. All right, both bikes, if you really stand back and look at them, they're both set up almost identically. Stem height, stem reach, stem width, crank arm length, gearing, saddle height, dimensions on the bike. The Mossy has a sloping top tube, whereas the Cannondale has a horizontal top tube. Okay, second, both bikes are 11 speed 105. One uses Mavic wheels that just spin like, oh my god, like butter. The Mossy, on the other hand, uses DT, Swiss. Doesn't quite spin as well. And to be perfectly honest, if they just loosen the load on the front bearings, it's been a lot better. So, and that also has to do with how tight you keep your quick release, how compressed those bearings become. Second big difference are the brakes. Even though the Mossy is a 105 bike, it did not come equipped with 105 brakes. And if we look down, there's not much tire clearance. Those are 700 by 25. But now let's look at the Cannondale. The Cannondale uses 105 brakes. They came with the bike, spec'd with a bike. It's really hard to see a full 105 build. Okay? But these are dual pivots. And dual pivots, as you can see, leave a lot of brake, a lot of space for the tires. So the tire space is there. Makes it kind of sweet. Also, the Cannondale is literally 3 to 3.5 pounds lighter with full bottle cages than the Mossy. The Mossy's extremely compliant simply because that frame, the way the geometry, the evolution geometry, makes it for a really stiff frame, so it really sprints well. It's more criterium style, whereas the Cannondale is more hill climbing style or road style. Which do I prefer? I don't know, I love a tight crit frame, but God, I love this long, comfortable frame. So that's the two bikes, a bit of a comparison. Yeah, you see a goofy saddle on top of the Mossy. We're gonna change that out right now, and then I'll do a short video on that.